Huzzah, Rangers. This is Phil Harris again here at the Jacks Rangers Show. I'm joined once again with Dave McVeigh. Dave, how the hell are you?
I am doing very well, Phil. How are you?
Not too bad, my friend. So we've got Atlanta slithering into Fort Quincy this weekend. It's going to be good weather, Friday the 13th, a night game. There's going to be fireworks afterwards. Prior to the game, there's going to be a brew fest with all of the South Shore breweries coming together to keep people happy with the brews. How excited are you for this?
I'm really excited. My family's going to be there. We'll be at the beer tasting. My wife's going to do the beer tasting. I'm gonna drive us. Mm-hmm. So we're looking forward to that. Fireworks after the show, and you know the match itself is going to be an absolute banger.
Yes.
So it should be a really good time. I like the idea of Friday night. I have to guess that this is going to be the biggest crowd of the season so far. Good weather, great event before that I think will pull some people in. Everybody going to the beer fest gets a ticket to the match.
Yes. So,
you know, I think it's really clever to have the beer fest end 30 minutes into the match. So you kind of have some overlap, you know,
yeah.
People who were trying to get to the rugby can, you know, they got an hour and a half, they can drink their beer and then go to their seats, you know, in time for kickoff. The people who are just there for the beer, you know, they're gonna close the place out. It's a Friday mm-hmm. night. They're gonna hang out. They're gonna take their time. They're gonna get half an hour of rugby exposure.
Yes.
You know, before last call, so to speak. And you know, what are they gonna do? They're gonna walk over to the beer tent where they get regular beers. They're gonna get themselves a $5 storm along, and they're gonna rock on up to the stands
yep.
and you know mill around and catch some rugby. So I think it's a really good promotion. I'm very hopeful that it's gonna have a packed house there, and should be very exciting.
Yeah, I'm super excited. You know, I get off work at 4:30. I'll be able to collect my girlfriend. We'll head right on down to Boston. We're staying at the Hojo's this time around, so should be a good time. We'll probably park there and just walk, you know, right on into the stadium and check everything out. Super excited about it.
Yeah. And it's superhero night. In addition
That's
to the
right.
beer fest.
Yes.
It's superhero night. I know they're going to do some stuff around that. It should be a really good time. So we'll see. I'm trying to source some superhero costumes for my girls right now. Mm-hmm. My 5-year-old definitely wants to be Hulk. That's her favorite because
nice.
he smashes stuff and she thinks that's hilarious.
Oh yes.
So we'll see where we end up. I would love to come as Fat Thor. That's my dream. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to find the long wig.
Right.
The Lebowski-esque bathrobe,
That's
sweater
true.
Situation, all that. I'm not sure if I'll be able to turn it up in time. But if you see me, just pretend I'm dressed as Fat Thor. I'm most of the way there already.
All right, I'll try to do that for you. You know, the costumes are going to be fun to see. You know, obviously the superhero theme, so I'm expecting to see a lot of, like, Spider-Man. You know, I'm sure Spider is going to be Spider-Man. That just makes so much sense, right?
I can't wait.
Yeah, I hope to see a couple of Batman out there. That's my favorite superhero of all time. There, more of a DC guy than a Marvel guy. So, just wanted to throw that out there. But yeah, I mean, also keep in mind that I had this idea a couple of weeks back. At this point, I was talking to Kenny,
yes.
and I was like, you know what? It's Friday the 13th. That's a night game. Jason Voorhees. That we got to have some Jason mask in the crowd, and I'm hoping to see quite a bit. I know I'll have two more extra that's going to Josh and his friend, and my girlfriend and I will have Jason mask. I know there's going to be others out there that have already purchased their Jason mask, so should be a good time.
Excellent.
Can't wait to see that. Yeah.
Yeah. Sure. Give them nightmares.
Yeah. Exactly. Let's talk about the preview. So Atlanta finds themselves in third spot in the Eastern Conference standings with 41 points, just 1 point off the pace from New Jersey in second right now, 8 wins, 4 losses with 341 points for, and points against is 280. That is a point differential of plus 60. Not bad. One thing that a lot of people are talking about right now with this Atlanta squad is their performance that they put in against lowly Utah at Utah last week, losing that game that no one predicted that they would lose. This is a team that last year was in the championship, if you guys recall, against LA. Of course, they lost that. But, oh, by the way, the last game of the season last year for the Jacks and the first ever at Fort Quincy was a big win for New England over this Atlanta squad. I think a lot of us Rangers were hoping, and I certainly was, that this Atlanta team – would, you know, kind of falter a little bit and drop off their form after their head coach Scott Lawrence was let go before the start of this season, but that has not happened. Of course, we can who can forget when the Jacks went down to the Snake Pit earlier this season and got a huge win over the Rattlers. Now the Snakes have to slither up to New England to face the mighty, mighty Free Jacks at Fort Quincy on Friday the 13th, no less. It seems like Atlanta ran out of gas in the last 20 minutes for the previous game that we faced them, you know, down there and at the Snake Pit. New England has secured playoff rugby this season, but I don't think this team will take its foot off the gas or its eye off the prize, which, of course, is the number one seed in the East, which gets us a first-round bye, which is crucial. One thing we know that Atlanta is they love to play they are a physicality type of team. They love to knock people around. I think this will be another slobber knocker between these two teams. A lot of people are wondering about the health of Bodine Waka. From what I saw myself, I have no reason to believe that Waka will not play in this game. Dave, what do you make of this Atlanta squad?
Yeah, to address the last thing first, I think Waka is probably I have no idea. I'm bad at diagnosing injuries from like watching anyway, you know. Yeah. It seemed like he was hurt, but not a major deal. I heard he'd walked up to the coach's boxes, means he's like doing stairs.
Yes.
I cannot imagine, like you said, I can't see him not starting. I think that he'll want to play and it looks like he'll be able to, just from how mobile he was after the game. Hoping they were just discretion being the better part of valor and making sure to get him some rest when he realized it was, you know, more significant than nothing. Mm-hmm. So we'll see. We'll see what happens with Waka, but I think he'll be there. Atlanta are going to bring clean set pieces. They're a good set piece team. They have a pack of cave trolls, very, very physical on offense and defense. They like to double tackle like we do, hold the ball up, slow the ball down. They like the old Samoan sidestep, you know, just run right through you. So we'll see what they can bring in terms of that. Coming off a 44-26, you know, butt whooping by Utah out in Zion Stadium, they're definitely going to be trying to make a statement. They've got that fueling them. They've got our win streak fueling them. So I expect a really hot Atlanta team this week. And I think it'll probably look a lot like that final match of the last season that you mentioned, just extremely physical.
Yeah.
And you could feel the impacts from up in the crowd. And I think that's what we're going to see. Their back line is no joke either. Their pack is very good and gets a lot of the attention, but they have a really solid kind of play executing back line. They can they can be real crisp there as well. So hopefully our fitness will carry us through like it did last time. It's going to be a big test for the Free Jacks. If we are pushing double digits on penalty count and we miss 30 tackles, you know, which is what we had stats wise this past week, we could be looking at a loss. So we're really going to have to turn up.
Yeah,
I think to make sure that we win this. Not to say that we're underdogs or take anything away from the players. It's going to be a significant challenge. Nothing can be taken for granted in sports generally. That's the reason we play the game, right? Mm-hmm. Not just decide who should win beforehand. But in this match particularly, we're going to have to wait 80 minutes and see. It's going to be really close. It should be great. It should be really good rugby.
I mean, this could be a preview of the Eastern Conference Finals right here.
Very likely, I think, yeah.
Yeah. This is an Atlanta squad that, you know, is going to want to snake bite us for sure. You know, I think they understand that this is a team that they obviously will see in the postseason, so they want to make an impression here with the folks, the Rangers out there at Fort Quincy. This is a game that definitely Atlanta could could win for sure. There's no doubt in my mind. We want to have this this invincibility type of attitude with Fort Quincy and this team with a 9-game winning streak. It's Friday the 13th, guys. Like, things could not go our way potentially. And that doesn't have necessarily do with just superstition. That's based on what we saw last week when playing this DC squad that rose to the challenge. And I expect Atlanta to do that. But, oh, by the way, Atlanta has a better roster than DC does and a better track record as well. This is a playoff caliber team, and they find themselves in third place. But they've been in second pretty much all season long up there at the top. So, and of course, earlier they were ahead of us in the standings, in the Eastern standings. So very good team. Physicality is going to be the big approach this time around. I mean, obviously the Free Jacks want that first place, the first round bye, being the first team in the Eastern Conference at the end of the season. I really hope that they're, and I don't believe that this is the case, but we're just kind of, talking our way through this preview here. I don't want them to take the foot off the gas because they've secured the playoffs. My whole thing at the beginning of the season, start of the preseason, was get your ass in the playoffs and we'll see what happens. Well, we find ourselves in first place with a 9-game winning streak. So this team's even better than what we predicted. So we want to be even better than that for sure.
Yeah, absolutely. Well put.
All right. So let's move over to key to the game. And I will go first here. For me, it's just all about we will tread, right? The rattlesnake is the symbol of Atlanta. There's the don't tread on me flag that has Revolutionary War tie-ins there. So we will tread. And what does that mean? People always say, like, of course, when they're listening to this, Phil, you're so metaphorical about these sort of things. You actually don't really talk about what happens on the pitch. So what I mean by we will tread is just match Atlanta in terms of physicality and do it, go even harder than they do, which may be very difficult to do. But then again, we saw this team, as I was saying earlier, Atlanta ran out of gas in the last 10, 20 minutes of the last game at the Snake Pit. I'm hoping that is the case again. So we just got these, heavyweight boxers just going, body blows, body blows, body blows, and eventually they're going to collapse. That is the hope, and we'll be able to run out winners. So we will tread.
Excellent. My key to the game, precision in the collision.
Love it.
I agree it's going to be very physical, and to me, more important than just battering your brain against the brick wall of contact is going to be contact height, good communication in the double tackles, slowing their ball down, and really slowing their ball down is one of the things that frustrated them big time the last time we played them. And slowing down the ball starts with making good contact in the tackle, so that when you get them to the ground, you're in a position where they're not presenting cleanly to their team. So collision precision, that's what leads to all those, all the ball slowdown and turnovers that we thrive on. It's kind of the building block of our defend to attack philosophy. And I think that if we can get that fundamental right, then we can win the game.
All right. I had forgotten a prediction, so I had to do it while we were, recording this. So my prediction is Atlanta 23, New England 24. It's going to be one of those squeaky bum time situations. Once again, Free Jacks fans out there, the Rangers, with, New England just winning by the thinnest of margins. I don't know how it's going to go down. Here's what I would love to see. All right. And folks at home, you've heard this before from me. Waka drop goal to win the game. I want to see it. It has to happen at some point. He's had a magical run all season long. He tried it not to win the game, but just to kind of put the icing on the cake 2 weeks ago, I believe it was, at Fort Quincy. So I want to see a drop goal to win the game this time around. How sweet would that be?
Very dramatic. It would be wonderful. Yeah. EB would be happy. You love Johnny Wilkinson, drop goal master.
Yes, sir.
My score prediction, pretty close to yours, 26-28. Free Jack's going to come out ahead, but I think it's going to be a good one. I think the set pieces are really going to be a place to watch, to see how the match plays out as well.
Love it. Any final thoughts before we get out of here?
Let's beat them. Let's rub their face in the mud. It's going to be a real fun close to the season. But like you said, don't take our foot off the gas.
Yep. Can't wait to see everybody there at Fort Quincy. Going to be a good one. Got the fireworks. Going to be great weather. Don't forget your Jason Voorhees mask, ladies and gentlemen. I hope to see everybody there. And all we got for you is one word in 3, 2, 1. Huzzah!
Huzzah! Woo!